In the previous video, we have discussed what is a trait and how to execute that one. And you have found that a very similarity with the abstract Java classes with this trait in Scala. So now the question is coming in mind that where to use this trait and where we should not be. There is no firm rule, but here we can provide you some guidelines to tell where to use this trait and where you should not. If the behavior will not be reused, then make it in a concrete class. And it is not reusable behavior after all. So in case of concrete class, we know that we cannot go for further extension of that class. So that's why the extents cannot be done. So that's why there is no need or there is no scope of reusing the class members. If it might be reused in multiple unrelated classes, then make it a trait. Whenever these methods will be reused in multiple unrelated classes, then you should put those methods in a trait. Only traits can be mixed into different parts of the class hierarchy. If you want to inherit from it in Java code, use an abstract class. So if I want to inherit from the Java code, in the Java there is no concept of trait, there will be using the abstract class on the other hand. If you plan to distribute it in compiled form and you expect outside groups to write classes inheriting from it, you might lean towards using an abstract class. The last point is that if the efficiency is very important, lean towards using a class itself. So in this discussion, we have discussed that where to use the abstract class, where to use the traits, and where you should go for a simple class. Now this conception is getting clear to you that where you are going to use this trait in your Scala coding. Thanks for watching this video.